Now, up until now, I've made the reactions pretty simple, where we only had one material that's reacting with itself. Another type of aldol reactions are cross-aldol reactions, or ones that happen between two different molecules. So if, for example, we have one molecule of acetaldehyde and one molecule of propionaldehyde, and I treat that with a strong base, like OH-. Now this reaction just got a lot more complicated. It's not just a little bit more complicated, it's a lot more complicated. So let's look at why. The first question is, which proton gets deprotonated? Both of these molecules have a proton on a carbon, alpha to the carbonyl. So the hydroxide could come in and deprotonate the propanol, or hydroxide could come in and deprotonate the acetaldehyde. So let's look at what would happen in each of those cases. So at this point you might think, well, it's a little bit more complicated because we have two different enolates. Now we have to figure out if I have the enolate of the propanol, now that has two different things it can do, because either it can react with another molecule of propanol, or it can react with one of the acetaldehydes. And the same is going to be true for the enolate of the acetaldehyde. That can react with a molecule of the propanol, or it can react with another molecule of acetaldehyde. So here's your chance to get some practice. Try drawing out the products for all four of these mechanisms, and then come back and see how you did. You'll notice here that I drew this intermediate with two different colors again, the black part being from this original part from the enolate as it reforms a carbonyl. And so you might notice that I drew this methyl group coming off it going down. That's going to be this methyl group over here. And then I drew the other piece that it attached to, the other propionaldehyde, in red, just so we could kind of see the two different pieces. We need to reprotonate, of course. To get the final product. And again, here you can double check because we took a propionaldehyde and a propionaldehyde, so three carbons and three carbons, and so our product should have six carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's a good way to check to make sure that you drew it properly. So then if we do the second one, we have this electron pair coming over instead to an acetaldehyde, and this electron pair moving up. So here you can see we have a different product. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. Because we had 3 from the propionaldehyde and 2 from the acetaldehyde that merged together to make the aldol product. So now let's see what happens if we look at our other piece. All right, so I'm going to move that other piece over here so I have more room to draw the products. I've got two possible choices here. So now I've got the enolate made from the acetaldehyde. This electron pair will come back down, and this electron pair will go out and attack one of the carbonyls, either of the propionaldehyde or of the acetaldehyde. So if it goes out to the propionaldehyde, an intermediate, which can then be protonated. And again, you can number and count the carbons. We had a 2-carbon enolate of acetaldehyde reacting with a 3-carbon propionaldehyde, so we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. We'll talk about this more when we get done with all of them, but you'll notice that that's a different structure than the other 5-carbon structure that we made. All right, and then let's look at the last mechanism. The electron pair comes down to reform the carbonyl, and this electron pair, instead of going to the propionaldehyde, comes out and attacks another molecule of acetaldehyde, pushing that pair of electrons up. making this intermediate, and we reprotonate it again with water. And if we count the carbons here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons, which makes sense because we had a 2-carbon enolate and a 2-carbon aldehyde that reacted together to make 4 total carbons. So now you can see that there's 4 different products here. There's a 4-carbon product, there's a 6-carbon product, but then there are also 2 different 5-carbon products. This one is a straight chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, where this one only has 4 carbons in a straight chain and has 1 methyl group coming off of that. So there are 4 different possible products. So the take-home message of crossed aldol reactions is that crossed aldol reactions between 2 different molecules can be very bad. Because if you remember what organic chemists want to do, organic chemists want to control everything. And this is really uncontrolled and not controllable. We get 4 different products, and it's going to be a giant mess trying to clean it up.